Hi everyone, it's Catherine here from Chaos Creates. Thanks for joining me on my channel today. I'm here to share with you a layout I'm creating for Confessions of a Paper Addict, and I'm using the Catherine's Spring cut file. This was created by Virginia last year when I won a competition in the Facebook group. So I've gone ahead and cut it out on some white cardstock, and I'm using it with the Coco Vanilla Studio These collection. And I'm using this gorgeous wood grain as my background. I'm going to go ahead and sprinkle some Liquitex acrylic ink on in the titanium white. And I like just adding some of that to the background before I get started. So I'm also adding this Jen Hatfield gold spray and just dropping it on there. I do leave it dry off camera for a little bit, but it dries pretty quickly. Now I'm setting my florals in the center there, and I'm going to go ahead and add this border to my photo. I have printed this photo out in black and white and left a white border around the edge, but I'm just going to add this ombre sort of paper. It's the green into the peachy tones. I'm going to go through some other 6x8 papers and see what else I can add here, but I end up just using the one sheet. This photo is a photo of my niece and I when we were in a small little country town called Tarnagulla. This is where my mum and dad grew up, and it was where my grandma used to live, and we went back there recently at the start of this year. One of my aunties still lives there, and it was really lovely just to get away for the day. So I'm going to go ahead and add my photo tucked in underneath these leaf pieces. I haven't used this collection a lot, but I have a lot of ephemera, and I'm just working through what I can do in terms of clusters. And of course, that little girl and the lady holding hands is perfect for this photo. So I'm going to use it, but it needed something to sit on. So I'm going to add some sort of word there. I've got family at the moment, but I do end up changing that out. And I really like this mason jar with the houses and the trees. So I'm going to use that. And that little a sort of signpost there that says home. Although this isn't my home, it definitely feels like home. Walking down this laneway near the park, it just felt like home. You know, we used to go and visit my grandma a lot when we were younger. And so it was just fitting. So I put that together there for that spot where the lady and the girl can rest or sit or stand on, I should say. And I've added the picture perfect moments, and that's going to become my title, but I wanted to add a lot more florals around that to make it sort of stand out a little bit more. Like I said, I didn't back the cut file, but I thought about adding some more florals in, or, you know, and some leaves tucked in around it, but I decide not to. I just go ahead and sort of build out this floral cluster around the title. I've also pulled out the puffy stickers here, and they are gorgeous. They're tiny and they're really great to use around the page. So I am just, like I said, tucking in some florals. And while I'm doing that, I'll let you know that I've left a link below to the cut file in the Etsy store. And I have also left a link to the Confessions of a Paper Addict Facebook group. Go ahead and join there. You just have to answer a couple of questions and you will see the latest releases coming up. And also there's a free cut file every month. And I can tell you it will be well worth checking out what's coming up over the next couple of months, because I've seen a sneak peek and it's super exciting. So make sure you go ahead and join Confessions of a Paper Addict there on Facebook. So as you can see, I'm popping some of these die-cut ephemera pieces up on foam. Others I'm just sticking down with my wet adhesive straight onto the page. And yes, I'm just adding a little bit of dimension. And like I said before, I'm just filling out these two kind of clusters. Because this floral piece kind of goes in a slight diagonal, I'm working on that. And I am just adding some tiny little puffy hearts around these clusters, and I thought they were super cute. So, you know, this layout came together pretty quickly. I'm just going to add this puffy word sticky here that says love this. So together, love this. And I'm just sorting through a few of these die cut pieces, I'm going to add these butterflies. So I do go ahead and sort of bend these butterflies up and just stick them in the center. This then helps create some of that dimension without adding too much bulk to this layout. So I have picked these butterflies just being in a few different sort of colors just to add to those color tones around. And then I felt like the layout was missing something and I couldn't work out what it was, but I do go ahead and try and add this border. I was using a gel pen here and it just wasn't working. So then, you know, I try a few times and it was just being really painful. I don't know whether it's not run out of ink, but it just, you know, the ball wasn't rolling properly. So I sort of try and get around the page, but it just wasn't standing out enough. So I go ahead and pull out this Stabilo white pencil and it stands out really well. I haven't used it before. It's brand new to me. So that was fun to kind of create that border around the edge. And I really just felt like it finished the layout. So I do, you know, I draw around the edge and then I do make some scribbly marks just on the edge of two corners. And that's it for my layout. Thanks for joining me today. I'll leave you with some close-ups.